All right, you ready to be famous? All right, here we go. Okay, so what we're doing today is we're going to be cementing a laser sintered expander. The bands are custom laser sintered. All right, so there was no fitting. No separate is necessary because it slides right onto the teeth without going in between the contacts. So what we've done already is we've tried this in the patient's mouth to verify that it fits, and as usual, it fits perfectly. What we're going to do now is we're going to etch the entire surface of her upper molars so they're ready here. The other thing we're going to do, if you look closely here, these are already micro-etched inside. We're also, however, just to make sure we get extra adhesion of the Bandlok, which we're going to use, we're going to place some Assure on here and cure it. So we're going to do that first while I'm prepping the teeth, okay? All right, so you're going to open up real big. You're going to put your chin up for me, kiddo. Good. All right, so we have our standard etch here. And we're going to etch not only the buccal, also the lingual surface, the palatal surface of the first molar, and also over the occlusal a little bit. The band does wrap over the occlusal a little bit, so we want to make sure wherever it's there, it's going to be bonding. And you have to remember with these types of expanders, there's very little mechanical retention because we're not fitting the band up through the gingival margin in between the contact on the tooth. So we are relying on bonding to retain the appliance. So you got to make sure that you etch the entire tooth, including the occlusal surface here. All right, so we're going to leave that right down for me. Bite. We're going to leave that 30 seconds. I'm going to rinse that off. All right. Our assistant is finishing. Take a look over here. She's already put the Assure Plus. The Assure on there. You can use the Assure Plus too. Either way, it doesn't matter. But we like these syringe tips for the Ultra Bandlok Blue because it makes it easier to place the material in there rather than the standard syringe. All right, so now we're ready to rinse them out. A lot of water, kiddo. Good. I'm going to suck that all out, right? Open up a little bit. Now, alternatively, if you have a tough patient to manage, you can use the full NOLA here. You can put the tongue guard in there if you like. Most of the time, we don't find it necessary. All right, so you're going to open as big as you can now. Super wide. Put your chin up for me. Good. All right, so we're going to have the patient with her mouth open wide, her chin up as much as she can. Great. Now we're going to dry, it's just air. We're going to dry your teeth, okay, kiddo? Good. Open up real big. Good. As big as you can. Good. Good. Open it super wide. Bigger, bigger. All right, so now what we're going to do is we're going to paint our primer on the teeth, which is the Assure, and we're going to paint it on the lingual and buccal surfaces. Over here on the buccal surfaces. I'm going to go over the occlusal a little bit because, like I said, it's going to wrap over the occlusal a little bit. Open up really big. Good. And then we're simply going to place the expander in the mouth. Okay. So here's our loaded expander with the Bandlok. Okay. Open up real wide. We're going to seat it with our fingers, light finger pressure, or strong finger pressure, really. We're going to take two cotton rolls. We're going to have her bite it in place. Squeeze really tight. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Good. Open up. Stay open real wide. Put your chin up. Now we're simply going to wipe away the excess. Open up real big. Okay. What you're going to want to do with these appliances too is you tend to get more cement coming out from the lingual surface. So you don't want to get that stuck underneath the appliance. Traditional expander, you're often going to get it coming out the occlusal. Okay. But in this case, we tend to get more of it in the lingual. On the gingival, I'm sorry. All right, so you can see I'm holding it in place on the screw area here. I'm keeping pressure. And then we're simply going to cure it. This is a 3-second light. Usually I'll give 3 rounds of that. I'll go over each cusp individually. Open a real big fiddle. We're almost there. Okay, I'm coming the other side. And again, the whole time I'm making sure we have pressure here, because again, it doesn't grab the teeth. It does a little bit, but we don't want it to move during the curing process. And take a look inside there. All right, there we go. There's our laser sintered expander. All done.